Hello children, as you know already we are going to the exercise part of our chapter lesson 13. Today we will do part B1 of your exercise. Now let us continue what is given in this. Here we are given some filling the blanks and I will write answers for you here and you will just copy it in your textbook. Children, you can take out your pencils and erasers so that can complete this exercise with me. Okay, so I will read out the sentence. At breakfast, we need a coffee in a. At breakfast, we drink a coffee in a cup and saucer. Coffee or tea. किसमें लेते हैं? Cup या saucer? We need a cup and a saucer. So I will write your answer. Number 1, true or believe? We should dash and dash our food well before we swallow it. We should bite and chew our food before we swallow it. कितने बार आप लोग क्या करते हैं? हमें खाना दिया है, don't like to eat that food. Your that is not your favorite food. What you will do? You will burn it, right? Or you will swallow it as far as early as possible. Children, never do this. Always bite and chew your food properly so that digestion becomes properly and you remain healthy. If the food is not digested properly, you will fall sick. You don't take big bite of food. You should take small bite of food and chew it properly and then you swallow it. So always, whenever you eat your food, eat it properly, chew well. And do not talk while eating your food. So next answer is bite and chew. We should put away our dash while eating food. We should put away our mobile phones while eating food. Children, when we were young, we used to have phone at our house, but it was at one place fixed. We had to go there to pick the phone if phone comes. But now what happens? Our mobile phones are always with us. Wherever we go, we take this mobile phone. So that is a benefit that you don't have to go and pick the phone. But children, when you eat, at least when you eat and when you sleep, keep your mobile phones aside. Don't keep on playing with the mobile phone. Don't keep on chatting with the mobile phone while eating, specially. And before sleep also, before 1 hour, you need to stop your mobiles before sleeping, before 1 hour of sleeping, when you go to bed. You need not touch the phone. Subah uthke bhi aapko phone uthana hota hai. Why? Why it is needed? If we talk about parents, parents we understand they have some other. But being a child, being a kid, it is not necessary that you need mobile phone in the early morning, you need mobile phones. When you are having your food, you want to see that cartoon and then you will reach no children. Just stop. If you are doing this, stop this habit. It is not a good habit. That means what will happen? You will not chew your food well. You will not get give attention to your parents or the person who is sitting alone. Right? And you are always busy with your phone. So you need to stop this. Okay? So your answer should be mobile phones. Number 4. I keep a dash napkin beside my dash when I eat. Answer should be I keep a folded napkin beside my plate when I eat. So if you have a dining table at your place, your mama must be arranging the table before you all come to eat. Before you all sit for eating, your mama must be arranging the plates and the napkins and fork and knife, and then you start your food, right? If you are happy to Now, next question, guys. Your answer should be number 4, folded and plate. And next we have, I use dash and dash to cut and eat my food. As I said, a knife and fork, people are using a table. This is, I use knife and fork to cut and eat my food. Am I right? Number 5. Now, as I said, in previous modules, when we were doing some of this knife and all, I said K-N-I-F-E here, K is silent, so we pronounce it as knife and fork. Last we have number 6. It is good manners to always dash after finishing a meal. It is always good manners to say thank you after finishing a meal. Suppose someone invites you at their place for a nice dinner. After having your dinner, you should always at least show that respect that they have called you and you need to say thank you to them for the lovely dinner. So, we'll say, say thank you. Children, if your place is very less, like your bed is here, very short, small bed is here, you can write below the length also, no problem. So here we have completed your part B1 we have completed. We will see the next exercise in next part. So I am doing this small exercise with you so that you are able to complete this exercise. Otherwise if you will not complete, you will not get interest in doing. So small part you can complete with me, and by the time you need to read the chapter also, otherwise you will not get